Hey folks, so in this video we're going to talk about the role of our feet in our movement. We know that movement starts with the feet, right? We're running, we're jumping, we're walking. Anytime we're mobile, we're using our feet, so all movement starts with the foot. Well, do you know that besides moving with our feet, we can also strengthen our core using our feet, because the feet are actually a part of our core, right? So we're actually going to go through a technique now called short foot, where not only will we strengthen the intrinsics of the foot, but we will actually fire foot to core, hip complex, glute sequencing to make all of this stronger. And the more solid all this is, the better it is for our feet and our gait when we're walking, running, and moving. All right, so let's take a look at this. First of all, we have to understand what we're activating here. The primary muscle we're looking at is this muscle on the bottom of the foot. Okay, when I raise my toe like that, you'll see this right here, this tendon pop right out. That is the abductor hallucis. That's our target muscle. So how we want to implement this is like this. I want you to follow me. I want you to pick a leg. I'm on my left leg. First of all, when we stand on this leg, we want to stand on what we call the foot tripod, which is first and fifth metatarsals and the heel. So we want to be on the ground, trying to evenly distribute weight between those three points. All right, you can also, I want you to actually touch down and steady yourself with the other leg. I have reasons for that, I'll tell you about that in just a minute. Now, get yourself situated. Soft bend in the knee, you must have a bend in the knee. You can't be locked out, bend the knee. Foot tripod, even weight distribution. Next up, lift the toes, separate the toes, set them down. Just by setting them down, you have more skin contact than the ground. And side note here, the foot is not only a biomechanical structure, but it's also a neuromuscular structure. We have so many receptors, sensory receptors, on the bottom of our foot that alone can stimulate the nervous system. Okay, we want to actually activate our nervous system using our bare feet. All right, next thing, what we're gonna do now, hands go on your hips, steady yourself here. You've got your toes lifted, separated, and you set them back down again. Now I want you to dig that big toe down into the ground, then follow by digging the rest of the toes down. Make sure you have a bent knee, all right? And relax the toes, okay? I'm gonna do this from more of a lateral view. Again, dig the big toe down in, dig the rest of the toes down in, have a bent knee. You should see the arch of the foot, you should feel it lifting a little bit. If you don't, just keep doing it anyway. Sometimes people with flat feet have a little trouble with this. Or if you have a bunion, you may have some trouble with this also. Relax the toes, dig in again. I want you to tell me, answer, I won't hear you, we're on video, but I want you to answer this question. When you're digging these toes in, what do you feel? Let's relax again. Now I want you to think about this. Dig the toes in. Knee has to be bent. What do you feel right here? Anything? A lot of you probably feel some glute activation right here. How about some inner thigh here, adductors? And of course the bottom of your foot is activated too. Relax the feet. Let's go to the other side, try the same thing. Foot tripod, lift the toes, separate them, set them down. Steady yourself with the other foot. Knee is bent, hands on the hips, boom, dig the toes in. As soon as I dig it in, I'm feeling it right here. It's amazing. Relax the toes. Dig in again, bend knee, always bend the knee. Why? Leave those toes down while I tell you. If you're like this, with a locked knee, well, you can try it if you want. You're not gonna feel these babies fire up, okay? Relax the toes. If your leg is, this is like a light switch. You lock the knee out, you turn the glutes off. Dig your toes in with a locked knee, right? I mean, tiny bit, but like nothing. Bend the knee, dig the toes in, boom. And if you can, bring this leg off the ground now and do it, because if you're not steadying yourself here, after you get the feeling of, you know, what this feels like, you're gonna hit more glutes. Relax the toes, let's do it one more time. Dig those toes in. I'm feeling it. Gotta love it, right? So, why is that important? Well, there's a few different reasons. First of all, we have a lot of people out there. This is very common. I see it very often. They have like what we call an everted or pronated foot type. I'll call it everted. Okay, that's where you're kind of in like this, all right? Your arches are downward. What happens in that position? Basically, this little rotation down here and here. So your tibia and your femur rotate, turn to your knees. You see your knees go in a little bit, okay? What's this looking like, right? Anterior pelvic tilt. Instead of normal, I go into this. I'm exaggerating slightly, although there are many people who are like this. They walk around like this. That's one foot type. Well, that foot type, many times, if they've gone to a podiatrist, I happen to work for a podiatrist. And so this is what we do to help to treat our clients or patients to get them to either avoid orthotics or get out of them eventually. All right, but go to a podiatrist, they'll throw you into an orthotic to help block that motion of the foot rocking down. So you put that back into a neutral foot posture. That's okay, but if you can do it on your own, it's much better. Much better if you can strengthen the intrinsics of the foot instead of relying on something to support you. Okay, so this is one way for a lot of people to get out of orthotics, bring their feet back to neutral position. Because when your feet are neutral, you're gonna move better, you're gonna take in energy better, you're gonna release it better. This is gonna be more solid, and the more solid this is, the better off your feet are gonna be. The chances are your gait pattern is going to improve, your walking pattern is gonna improve. All right, so let's progress this before we sign off, okay? I wanna show you one thing we can do. We're gonna do a squat. It's our only exercise. We'll do a few of these on each leg, and we'll progress with some things we can do to activate more and feel more during the process. All right, so in the next videos in this series, though, we're gonna go into a whole workout using short foot in our movement. All right, so just so you have a concept and understanding of what to do, we're gonna do this now. So when we get to the next video, we just get right into the workout. So here it is. You're gonna pick a leg. You're going to stand on the foot tripod. You're going to lift the toes, separate them, set them down. Now, I just want you to do something really simple here. If you need to steady yourself with this foot, go ahead. Lift the toes, separate, set them down. Leave the toes relaxed. Don't dig them in, but come down. At the bottom of the squat, dig those babies in. Dig in the toes, big toe and all of them. Dig them in and push up. Relax the toes at the top. Come down. Push up with toes dug in. Every time you push up, your toes are digging into the ground. Down, dig in the toes, tips of the digits, right down into the ground as best as you can, and push up. Let's do two more. Down, dig the toes in, come up, relax the toes at the top, down one more time, dig them in, push it up. I'm telling you, boom, right there, I feel it. I also feel it here a little bit, here a little bit. All through here, pretty much foot to core sequencing. Remember, your hips, your glutes, all this, and your feet are part of your core. Let's get on the other leg and progress this so you can feel a little bit more. Foot tripod, evenly distributing weight. Lift the toes, separate, set them down, relax the toes. Now, this time we're gonna come down. When you dig in the toes, I also want you to lift. Engage the pelvic floor muscle, lifting it towards the ceiling, all right? And I want you to use body tension. Pull in your belly. So, relax everything right now. Come on down, dig in the toes, suck in the belly, lift the pelvic floor, and push up. Boom, relax, come down, dig in, lift pelvic floor, pull in the belly towards the spine, come up. Relax at the top, down. Dig in the toes, pull in belly, lift pelvic floor, come up, two more, ready? Relax toes to the top, down, dig them in, engage it all, fire it up, one more, come on down, dig it in, give it all you got, boom! What'd you feel that time? A little bit more in here, right? That's because you're intentionally tensioning that area. You're lifting the pelvic floor, that's part of our core also. This, folks, has shown in studies that after a few weeks doing workouts of this type, 20 to 30 minutes a day, three times a week or so, within a matter of 4, 5, 6 weeks, first of all, your glutes, after 2 weeks, studies have shown, Blackburn is the study, glutes strengthened by up to 200%. A lot of ankle sprains and other issues down there are a result of weak core, but especially weak glutes. So you've got to strengthen those glutes, it's very important. All right, but we also know that after 4, 5, 6 weeks, we have stronger complex, which helps landing mechanics of the feet, gait pattern improves, and for those who are in that everted foot type, a lot of times they're starting to show signs of correction. Sometimes they're already corrected after a few weeks. And they have a neutral foot position. The knees no longer fall in. And they go from this to this, okay? Everyone's different because we all of our bodies are different. We're all gonna respond differently to exercises. But one thing we know is that our anatomy is pretty much the same. It's just what our issues are that we're dealing with. So this also, this short foot technique, especially when we get into barefoot training in the next video, which is an entire workout, 20 to 30 minute workout. When we do this, when athletes do this, especially before they put on their shoes and start training normal, do you know the injury rates on athletes who do this barefoot training, short foot, injury rates down 70%. Powerful stuff. I want to make sure I share it with you. If you have any questions, just shoot me an email, drop me a line, text me, call me, whatever. I'm here for you. Enjoy this. Do it. Practice it. Strengthen that core. Fire up those glutes. Get your feet working better. Because you get those working better, you're going to walk better, move better, run better, everything. You're just going to feel better. You're going to perform better. All right, folks, thanks for tuning in. Have a great day.